Hello, John.
Hello, good Hello. Evening.
Good evening, how are you? It's always a privilege to have you here, really. Okay.
Likewise, yeah.
Okay, yeah. So I'm talking to the right person here, about Nirvana.
Yes, I was the first person to ever interview them. I interviewed them for Sounds, music paper.
Yeah.
Just before their first single came out, about, God, it's 20 years ago, mm-hmm. I interviewed them on the phone. It was a phone interview. And I interviewed him a couple of times after that. We stayed with him in New York about 3 days and shared a flat. So I got to know him quite well. This is just, that was second interview at the time of Bleach when that came out.
Yeah. And what about the Reading Festival and the album, you know? You were there.
I was at the Reading Festival gig, And it's one of the classic gigs. It's the gig where they really broke through. Mm. They already headlined Reading's massive, but that's the point where they became really big, isn't it? That's a gig everyone talks about, and I think it's a really important moment in the band's history. You know, it's when they go completely like the biggest band in the world. It's at that moment, really.
Mm.
I remember the first time they played Reading. That was when Nevermind came out, and the record label pressed 4,000 copies in England because they didn't realise how big the band was, and the record sold out in about a day because the whole thing just took off so quickly when it finally got to hear about it.
John, can we say that Kurt Cobain was an everyday, in a sense, rock and roll guy who became a rock and roll star? I mean, must be very difficult, you know.
I think there's a lot of pressures with being famous that people don't think about. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's no privacy. You know? I think he was a very sensitive soul. He probably wasn't the right kind of person to be in that kind of situation. But it was something he really wanted as well, because when you read these diaries, that's what he wanted more than anything, to be in a really successful band.
Yeah.
But I think people don't realise what it's like when you're really successful. I think probably he wanted to be as big as Sonic Youth, and that's kind of size is the size you can actually handle.
Yeah.
But it just got crazy for him, didn't it? Just really crazy.
Yeah. A lot of pressure, yeah.
It was a sad day when he died.
So young, yeah, of course. Kurt goes in love with Buzzcocks, in a way. Steve Diggle.
He liked a lot of great music. Mm. I think one of the weird things was when they got really massive, all the bands that copied them didn't really understand. A lot of the bands that came afterwards, you know, like the grunge bands, like Alice in Chains, and those kind of groups.
The whole scene,
Just were pure rock, long-haired rock bands. They didn't realise that Nirvana came from the Raincoats and underground British bands. As much as they loved rock music, they loved Black Sabbath, they loved Black Flag, but they also loved a lot of like indie bands and like, of course, the Vaseline's, which they covered about 3 times, you know.
Mm.
So he really knew his music, because at the time the Vaseline's in the UK were a tiny band who sold about 200 records, and one of the people who was a fan of theirs was Kurt Cobain, which is a pretty lucky thing to happen to you.
And John, what about the legendary Membranes? You're back in business. Tell us some details.
Yeah, my Bloody Valentine asked us to reform to play All Tomorrow's Parties in December.
Yeah.
December the year, Saturday 5th. So we've reformed and
it's great,
we're going to do it. I think it'd be good fun. We're not going to like tour the world. But if anybody wants, we're just going to do like cool, interesting gigs instead of playing.
I'm sure.
Spend the whole 80s playing all the horrible ones.
Okay, John, thank you very, very much for your time, really. Okay?
Oh, no, thanks for your time. No, I'll get back to touring Germany. I'm in Chemnitz tonight in South Germany.
Okay, cool. Have fun. Okay, bye-bye.
Okay, Dimitri, thanks a lot.
Okay,
bye.
Okay, John, bye.